obviously Eric Carter and Kevin Anderson have really carried us so far in the early part of the season.
And Colin Gass, he played 31 games total at George Washington, but really not significant minutes. Mm-hmm. So this is the first time in heavy rotation. He got a block shot. He ran the floor after the block, got a basket, scored with his back to the basket. What are some of the things that you're working on with Colin to get him more acclimated to the speed and to the competition of college basketball?
Yeah, I mean, I think it starts in practice every day. Him and Eric Carter have starting to figure out how to play together, play off of each other. We're starting two big guys. And I look at Colin as really a stretch forward, but we want to try to post him up a little bit too when Eric's not in the game. Though we got into a good segment where he was the only big guy on the floor. He scored it with his back to the basket a couple times. And he has done a great job kind of altering shots around the basket. That's the one area that we saw last year in practice, his ability to play post.
We should have good timing here, Benny. It looks like we're going to go to the anthem right now. Just keep it, so we should be all right. Have an extra 30 ready, just in case. We should get it. We should be going right into the anthem.
frozen turkeys are
say
only
it again.
39 cents a pound.
You want me to add a commercial? Or no?
Yeah, have it ready.
Your choice of pumpkin, harvest, or Dutch apple. Or
I think the time is pretty good.
Just $3.99 each. Restrictions and exclusions apply. For complete details, go to acmemarkets.com/rewards.
Just keep it. Listen
this
to the anthem.
This is Dr. Michael Wax's first day with the Peaks, the team of top docs taking care of Delaware from the beach to the bridge and beyond. For more FSO information, go to our website, firstaidortho.com.
With Domino's week-long carry-out deal, you can carry out large three-topping pizzas and now medium three-topping handmade pan pizzas for $7.99 each. It's fantastic news.
Cut. Puns?
You mean pans? Calling all pan addicts for two layers of cheese on crispy golden crust. So grab your panty packs, because Domino's large three-topping pizzas and medium three-topping handmade pan pizzas are $7.99 each. It's pandemonium. Fantastico. Carry out only. Just ask for this limited time offer. Prices, participation, and charges may vary.
When you get behind the wheel of a Chevrolet, you're driving dependability year in and year out. Check out the entire award-winning lineup at ChevyDealer.com.
All right, we'll be good.
Are you facing a financial crisis because of nursing home bills? Do you need help staying in your home? The team at Estate and Elder Law Services can help you qualify for Medicaid benefits to cover nursing home costs or care at home and preserve your savings. Located at 2961 Centerville Road, visit Estate and Elder Law Services online at www.emes.com or call 302-651-0113. That's 302-651-0113.
It's value days at participating Shell, Exxon, and Dash-Ins throughout
you hear
Delaware.
You right, Todd?
Yeah. The blue good. And red signs at participating Exxon and Shell stations offering savings on fuel. You're listening to Blue Hens Basketball on 94.7 WDSD, Dover, Wilmington. This is Blue Hens Country. WDSD, you're listening to Delaware Men's Basketball on New York for UD.
Welcome into the Bob Carpenter Center. Thank you for spending part of your Sunday with us. I'm Scott Klatchen alongside Ty Perry on 94.7 WDSD-FM, celebrating 20 seasons as your home for Blue Hens Sports. Delaware at 3-1 on the season, taking on Wilmington University. The Wildcats 1-2 out of Division II. A local game, good for the state of Delaware, and hopefully good for a Delaware's win-loss column as they were able to take care of a team from Wilmington's conference, Chestnut Hill, earlier in the week with a 100-62 victory. Let's get you the starting lineups brought to you by the Delaware State Education Association, DSEA, standing strong for student success. Nominate an all-star in education by going to WDSD.com and clicking contest. First, for the Wilmington University Wildcats, Tyler Norwood, a 5'9 freshman guard from Chester, Pennsylvania, averaging close to 16 points per game, leads the team in minutes over 36 per contest. Danny Walsh, a local Delaware resident from Bear, Delaware, graduate of William Penn High School, the sophomore, is another one of the guards on a smaller lineup team. Jermaine Head, 25 points per game, at a sophomore at Edgewood, Maryland, last year's Rookie of the Year in the conference. Dawson Greenwich at 6'5". Out of William Penn High School as well. Played at the Bob Carpenter Center in the blue gold game. So this is his second time, I suppose, playing on this floor. A local guy out of Bear, Delaware as well. And their tallest player for Wilmington, Denzel Haynes. 12 points per game, almost 10 rebounds per game. From Brooklyn, New York, a transfer from Northern Oklahoma Community College. The head coach, Dan Burke, in his fifth season for Wilmington. For Delaware, and I forgot about the board here, Todd. They're playing like this intro video now. I thought we could get on with the game here. Yeah. But we have the intro video that's playing. And again, the excellent board. If you haven't been to the Bob Carpenter Center, brand new video board here. Pretty exciting as I look at that. It's static, but I'm sure it's
right.
It'll continue.
Yeah.
It's impressive. That's for
very
sure.
Very impressive.
Got to get to the Bob Carpenter Center and check it out. Let's get to the starting lineups for Delaware. It hasn't changed all season long. Kevin Anderson is the point guard, a sophomore, averaging close to 4 assists per game. The shooting guard, Darian Bryant, he's got 8.8 points per game, but he gets the task of each team's biggest scorer. He's Delaware's toughest defender, so the captain, Darian Bryant, a redshirt senior from Bowie, Maryland. The small forward, Ryan Johnson, one of the captains, a graduate student transfer from Mercer. Power forward, Eric Carter, not many playing better than him to start the season. 20 points per game, 9.5 rebounds per contest. And Colin Goss is the center, 6 points per game, 7 blocks on the year, leads the team. The head coach, Martin Inglesby, in his third season. The staff
Bill Phillips, Corey McRae, Torian Jones, the assistants, Pat Rogers, operations director, and Danny O'Connor, director of development. Delaware will wear their home white jerseys with blue Delaware across the chest, blue numbers, yellow trim, and Wilmington University will wear their road black jerseys, green Wilmu across the chest, and a white trim. The officials in this one, Brian O'Connell, Nathan Farrell, and Evan Burrows. We're excited to get things started for you here on 94.7 WDSD as the players come out. What do you think of the board? They had the board when you were playing here. Pretty excited.
Yeah, it was interesting. I was here a couple weeks ago, and Keith Davis was like, did we have that board here? I was like, no, Keith, we didn't have it. I don't think they had that technology in the ancient days. The board is great. It's, you know, just brings a neat feature to the game.
Yeah, it makes the arena feel even bigger.
Yeah.
Really excited to have that second home game of the year. Delaware played on Tuesday against Chestnut Hill. So exciting stuff as the Delaware comes out on the floor. I'll tell you what, it does delay the start of the game, though, a little bit.
Yeah,
we're ready to rock.
Right. Yeah. Once we get this thing rocking and rolling, it'll be a neat feature. But it's really nice to have.
There you go. And the fans can watch it as it continues.
I'm actually watching it.
There you go. Wilmington coming out on the floor. Dawson Greenwich just showing some height at 6'5", but he seems taller than the listed 6'6" Denzel Hayes. So one thing that immediately you see when Wilmington comes out on the floor is that just a lack of height for this basketball team out of Division II.
Yeah, you know, that's the difference. You know, it's just the post player's height, guard's height. It's just difference in, you know, heights and levels. But that doesn't, you know, decrease the quality of fight tonight.
Well, that means Wilmington is going to have to try to speed it up.
Yep.
In this one, we're finally ready to tip it off. Eric Carter, Dawson Greenwich with the jump, and Carter easily tips it to Darian Bryan. We're underway with Kevin Anderson holding the basketball, bringing it up the floor, guarded by Head to the left side. It's Ryan Johnson. Johnson with a ball fake. Looking inside, always the first play designed to go to Eric Carter. Mid left block, he swings it across the court to Colin Goss. Goss, almost a 7-footer. He can shoot that three, decides not to. Here's Anderson on the dribble drive, and a foul is going to be called as Danny Walsh took the charge first on Kevin Anderson. And a nice charge taken by Danny Walsh.
Yeah, I think, you know, good drive, trying to get it to the basket. Maybe should have made a kick-out pass there to the corner, open Johnson in the corner.
Here's Wilmu. First possession as they go right to left as we see it here at the ValleyDaysFuel.com broadcast table. Norwood with the basketball. He'll let it fly from three off the mark front rim and no good in the hands of Eric Carter. Probably some nerves to start for Wilmu, you'd think.
Yeah, they're excited. You know, nerves. You know, Delaware too. You know, trying to, you know, playing a local team.
Johnson, corner, thought about the three, poked out by Head, gets it back inside the lane. Kick out to Anderson, one turnover for the sophomore on the first possession. 18:55, first half of basketball, 7 seconds on the shot clock. Anderson hesitates, gets inside, bounce past Bryant. Corner three with three to shoot off the mark, follows his shot and gets a reset.
Now, one of the things Coach talked about is, you know, limited turnovers. You know, hopefully we can, you know, kind of, you know, shut that down, have a little bit better assist to turnover ratio.
Good point. Delaware averaging 15 turnovers per game, 16 for Wilmington University. As a reset on shot clock, now down to 12. Goss has it on the wing, guarded by Greenwich. Goss with 6 inches on Greenwich. Corner, it's Anderson, 5 to shoot. Pull-up jumper contested off the backboard. Carter tips it, but Head has the basketball for Wilmu. Solid defensive possession for the Wildcats. Head, their top scorer, 25 points per game, a three over Johnson, a miss, and in the hands of Darian Bryant. Coach Burke probably thinking we could get a better shot later in the shot clock.
Yeah. Both teams are, you know, settling in, maybe taking some early quick shots. First time Delaware's got inside there, I think that's where they got to take advantage.
And they go inside to Carter for two. Yeah. First bucket of the game belongs to Eric Carter. And we spoke about Carter probably going to be able to get some opportunities against a smaller Wilmu team. 17:40 on the first half clock. First bucket to Delaware. Wilmu looking to score. A three on the way. Around and out. Three threes attempted by Wilmu. Oh, of three to start. Anderson dribble handoff. Ryan Johnson on the wing. Here's Darian Bryant. Couple dribbles and a bounce to Anderson. He'll line up with three on the other end and hit Kevin Anderson's sixth make from downtown this year.
Yeah. It's interesting. Wilmington is more of a go down the hill, get to the basket team. They're opening the game up, shooting all threes. We'll see if they can get to what they do well is getting to the paint and driving, getting to the basket.
Anderson makes it 5-0. Dawson Greenwich, corner. Thinking about the three was Denzel Hayes. Crossover. Head nearly lost his footing. Now a pass to Hayes with five to shoot over Eric Carter. Well defended, an air ball, and it lands out of bounds. 16-51, still looking for points out of Wilmington.
Yeah, Delaware's doing a good job of keeping them on the outside and also challenging those shots they're taking. Good start on the defensive end for Delaware.
Like you said, Wilmington wants to stay outside of that arc. They're going to have to hit shots, though, to make this a ball game if that's their strategy. 5-0 to start. Delaware operating on offense. Eric Carter, mid-left block, working on Greenwich. Double team comes. Head pushes Carter outside the lane. Now it's Bryant. Bryant with nine. Now it's Goss. Goss, the big fella, letting it fly for three, and he knocks down his fifth three-pointer this season.
It was good to see the inside-out play. Delaware could really have a lot of success drawing a double team on Carter and then kicking it out to an open three-point shooter there.
6'11 guys doing a little bit different than the way that the game was used to be played. Yeah. These guys stretch the floor now.
Yeah, they never go inside. I'm like, whoa, tallest guy in the building.
Walsh finally gets Wilmu on the board. It's 8-2, a pull-up jumper from 17, far side.
Yeah. Both teams are starting to get in a little flow. The nerves are settled down. Delaware is doing a good job of trying to get an inside-out play, and Wilmington is now kind of getting their guards going.
15-45. We'll take a break at the next whistle as Darian Bryant goes to Ryan Johnson. They work the ball around the perimeter. And a pass by Anderson, stolen away by Head. There's a turnover. Head down the floor. Bryant goes to block the shot. Contact no good on the basket, but Head will go to the free throw line when we come back. It's 8-2. Delaware on top of Wilmington, 15-33. First half of basketball.
The connection is strong. And as power flows, Delaware grows.
Good job, man. That was good. Just going to, timing was good.
Workers, Local 313 and the National Electrical Contractors Association believe every connection matters.
That's the so key for Delaware because they've got young, still got the talent and they're young, taking care of the ball.
Right.
Because really IBEW
local probably lead with that because a turnover led to the free throw, and I'll say, that's the second turnover on Kevin Anderson, and that was something that Coach Engels be talking to you about, take care of the basketball.
This is Dr. Michael Axe, first year Orthopedics, the team of top docs taking care of Delaware from the beach to the bridge and beyond.
It's good to see Coach Steinwetter over there. I don't know
if where is that?
He's in purple, right behind the bench. When the Chili
will use the bench. To include PRP
and then I see him. Pete Cloud next to him. He's a Delaware legend.
Okay.
They're good friends. They're cyclists.
Especially on patient testimonial Tuesdays. First day Orthopedics.
We'll need lots to talk about in this game.
Okay, great. Yeah, yeah.
Like, what's this? Hens Country. Here we go. 94.7 WDSD. Welcome back here to the Bob Carpenter Center. And for all the fans listening, a reminder that Acme offers free flu shots with most insurance. Plus, you'll earn 10% off your next grocery purchase up to $200 when you get your flu shot at an Acme pharmacy. Some restrictions do apply. I'm Scott Klaskin next to a Delaware basketball legend, Ty Perry. Ty, great to see you. Great to have you on the air with us. And as we went to break, a turnover by Kevin Anderson led to a layup on the other end, or two free throws coming up for Jermaine Head. That's something Coach Inglesby talked to you about yesterday at practice. How to control those turnovers.
Yeah, you know, Delaware has some young guards, real talented young guards. But one of the things, you got to be attention to detail and, you know, taking care of the ball. You know, that's something that, you know, you want your guards to have, assist to turnover, 2-1. Right now, Delaware is struggling on that end. And that's something that I think they'll prove throughout the season, is, you know, making sure they take care of the ball and value the basketball.
Yeah, that 15 turnover average on the season skewed a little bit from their poor performance up at St. Peter's, but well too high. They want to get that down to the 10 area maybe. That's where they were around last year. Second free throw good for Head. It's 8-3. Delaware leads. Full court pressure by Wilmu. Horton in the game for the first time. It's Horton, Anderson, Carter, Bryant, and Johnson. This is the lineup that Coach Inglesby has been going to with the first substitution pattern as Goss coming out and Horton being the sixth man this season. Yeah. Carter underneath, back on top to Horton, back inside to Carter. Two-man game. He whips a pass across the court to Johnson, open for a three. That's a good-looking shot from Ryan Johnson.
Yeah. Horton, he just moves Anderson off the ball because Anderson's a natural scorer. Him off the ball frees him up to be a little bit more of a scorer, have a scorer's mentality.
And he's got a scorer's mentality, slicing through the Delaware defense, but getting too far in, missing on the layup, and it goes back to Delaware. 11-3 on the count, back to Ryan Johnson's three-point shot. He was just 2 of 11 from three on the season, 30 40% shooting from the field overall. So that three probably could build the confidence.
Yeah,
for
it gets them going. I mean, because when you have Carter that's scoring inside as well, you have to have some guys be able to open the floor up and make some shots. When him making that shot, that's going to definitely help the team down the street through the season.
14-36, first half of basketball, 11-3, Delaware's lead. And they work the ball around the perimeter. Screen set by Carter for Anderson to the right side. Could Johnson do it again? He traveled with the basketball as his brain was processing, do I try another three or do I drive to the basket?
Yeah, go ahead and shoot that, man. You just made the last one. But I like the inside-out play. It's really opening up the outside shooting for Delaware. If they can make it, you know, if they can shoot a high percentage tonight, it'll be good for the Delaware Blue Hens.
And that's the only flaw thus far in this game, third turnover for Delaware, something we addressed coming back from the last media timeout. 14-18. First half of basketball. Tyler Norwood passing around ahead. Dribble hand off to Walsh. He's made the only jump shot, only field goal of the game for Wilmu. Walsh, the graduate of William Penn High School in Newcastle. Here's Norwood and a foul away from the ball. It's going to go against Wilmu. And the foul's going to go against Dawson Greenidge, the sophomore. That's the first on Wilmington University.
And that was something that Coach worked on yesterday, switching. You know, you can see that because most of their guard, with this small lineup, all the guys are really comparable. So they switched that ball screen, which caused that foul. So that's a really good defensive strategy but on Coach and the staff. And it's really taking the shot away from them, haven't been able to get any open shots or driving lane.
Yeah, Wilmington University, they want no part of inside the lane, it looks like thus far. Just one of six from the field at their first turnover. Anderson, he likes to drive the paint. He does so. Kicks out to Verretto off the bench and a miss from the corner three. Matt Verretto, the 6'7 freshman, now just 3-12 in the season from long range. Norwood trying to push the tempo a bit. He'll bring it back out. 13-39 for Wilmu as Haynes switches hands when he saw Carter. Might have got away from a traveling violation, but misses on the layup nonetheless. And it's Bryant across half court. Tempo being pushed by Delaware now on the other end. It's Carter inside. Double team comes. Right block. He dribbles. Passes out to Horton. Horton squares and fires on a three. It's still Horton is too strong. And a rebound by Norwood for Wilmu.
I know Coach probably want to see Horton throw that ball back into back into Carter, see if he can go. You know, he's got a little deeper, see if he can go to work there.
What's happened is Wilmu has been double-teaming Eric Carter as Greenidge shoots a three and hits the front run. Gets the shooter's roll. Dawson Greenidge, the triple good for the first time today for Wilmu. It's 11-6 Delaware. But Carter has done a good job of passing out.
Yeah, but they have to go back inside. Yeah. I mean, they have the distinct advantage with height. So inside out, back inside.
And Verretto, he thought about it twice, remained open for the top of the key, and the lefty hit the triple. It's now 14-6, Delaware on top.
Yeah, it's been good to see he's been playing well as a freshman, off the bench for Delaware.
Walsh lets a three fly, and Wilmington shooting a lot of threes, 2 of 6 in this game from downtown. After that miss by Walsh, here's Verretto. Thought about doing it again. Bounce pass is said to Carter. Carter one-on-one on Haynes. Haynes too small. Carter is fouled as he missed the layup. He'll go to the free throw line where he's shooting 77% this season. That's a high percentage for a guy his size that gets the line as much as he does.
And I like that. He went a little bit fast. He didn't wait for the double team to come. He just, just made his move. And that's something he's probably got to do is get a little bit deeper, go quicker. And with that size advantage, he will be able to, be successful. On the block.
He has the ability to get fouled. There was 10 games last season where he attempted more free throws than field goals in the game. I think that was a lack of touches last year. He's still getting a lot more touches this year the way he's playing.
Right.
But he's a guy that can go to the line and usually makes teams pay although he missed the first free throw there.
Yeah, that's a good stat. I mean, you shoot that many free throws and you shoot at a high percentage. You get a lot out of the interior play for Delaware.
We were hyping up Eric Carter for the free throw line. Yeah. Missed both free throws there. 14-6, a rare double miss from the stripe for Eric Carter. And now it's Norwood. Norwood, 5'9", freshman, having a good start to his season at 15.7 points per game. Here's Greenidge, the local product from Bear, Delaware. Into the game for the first time, Jordan Harding, another player from William Penn. A miss from Norwood from three, and now it's Ithiel Horton the other way, far sideline. To Verretto in the corner in front of the Wilmu bench. Horton straight away. One dribble and a pass to Verretto. Trying to bounce it inside of Carter. Instead to Cushing across the court. And Jacob Cushing spins one out. It was halfway down.
Wilmington is doing they're loading the ball side with Carter on that side. So that reverse three is going to be open for Delaware.
Not a good look at three from Jordan Harding on the other end. This will be a matter of whoever makes more threes is going to win.
I mean, that's right.
A lot of triples already being attempted. 2 of 8 goes Wilmu, 4 of 9 for Delaware. Just one shot for Delaware has come inside the arc. And it's come from Eric Carter. There's the second as he rolls that one in. So the only player to shoot inside from three, Eric Carter. He's 2-2.
Yeah, it's not a bad one to have a shooting inside of two. How well how his percentage is.
Almost 70% on the year for Eric Carter. A one-foot fadeaway miss from Norwood. Now running the floor is Verretto. Verretto to the rim, missing on the Euro step layup, but a tip-in is good for Eric Carter, and Dan Burke wants to talk about it. We'll take a break with Will Mew. They call a timeout on the floor, and we'll be back in a moment with Delaware up 18-6, 10:56 left in the first.
University of Delaware football powered by State Farm. Go with the one that's here to help life go right. Talk to an agent today.
Well, there you go, man. This
State
is going to be a blowout. So.
Yo.
We'll have some time to talk.
It's good. It's good. Delaware's playing. I mean, it's good to see it. We talked earlier how when you're playing against a team that's not as good as you, how do you start? I thought they start really well on the defensive side. They're really taking a lot of what they do well away from them. And now I think they're asserting themselves.
I like to see, like, Ed, Norwood, like, maybe try to penetrate a little bit.
Well, I also thought that they would be more up-tempo, right, getting the ball, pushing up. They really haven't been able to do that.
Court stuff, they're not getting good looks.
I think what happens is if when you score or get good shots on the deep, on the offensive end, it really helps your defensive transition, right, and it keeps everything in front. You know, so.
Your commute just got easier with Delaware Easy Pass.
But you also see the glaring talent difference. You know, Delaware is, you know, size, talent, guys can shoot, multiple guys can handle, make it easy. Moving off the dribble.
Here we go.
On 94.7 WDSD and iHeartRadio.
10:56 to play in the first half. A timeout taken on the floor by Dan Burke. Fifth season as the head coach of Wilmington University. Sent us to a break. Reminder that a portion of this broadcast is presented by First State Orthopedics, the team of Top Docs taking care of Delaware from the beach to the bridge and beyond. Visit firststateortho.com. I'm Scott Kvatskin alongside Ty Perry. Love to welcome you into the Delaware Blue Hens radio network. And so far, so good for the Blue Hens. They've come to play today and really doing it on both ends, but standing out defensively. They're holding Will Mew to 2 of 12 from the field.
You know, Delaware keys was keep the ball in front, you know, not allow them to get anything in transition, and challenge threes. And they've started the game really well on the defensive end. And it's helped them on the offensive side as well.
Wilmington University just 1 of 7 from long range in this one. 2 of 12 overall, 17% head in the game. He's lost his footing a couple times. I wonder, he's the only one that seems to be slipping, though, as a three is missed, an air ball for Danny Walsh. And you wonder if some of these local kids, Danny Walsh being one of them, William Penn High School, are pressing a little bit, probably got some friends and family at this big game at the Bob Carpenter Center.
Yeah, they definitely are, and they'll settle in. But it's exciting for them, you know, to be playing at the university, where all your friends and family can come.
Verretto with threes, made one, can't connect on another. Back tap by Colin Goss, and rebounded by Harding. Thrown away by Ithiel Horton, though, and a quick layup on the left side after the turnover.
He's going to be a really good player, Delaware. Strong, look like a football player, kind of. 6'3", 6'2", 6'3". Good body, good frame. Good player.
Coach is really excited about Ithiel Horton. A winner came from Roselle Catholic High School, won the Tournament of Champions in New Jersey. That's the state championship. Carl Anthony Towns won that tournament when he went to school at St. Joseph Metuchen as head, trying to get inside. I like the idea. Probably could have got a better shot. It was blocked by Darian Bryant. But Will Mew is going to have to try different ways to operate offensively. Yeah. That's one of them.
Bryant is, you know, he's an unsung hero for this group. I mean, he does a lot of little stuff. Guards the best player on the other team. He's doing a really good job of slowing head down early in the game tonight.
20-6 is Delaware's lead. Under 10 minutes, Will Mew doesn't realize there was no reset on the shot clock. It has to be a shot clock violation. When Head's initial shot went up, it was blocked by Bryant. And a no reset, Will Mew did not see it in a shot clock violation. They were still passing the ball around.
That's the point guard. Point guard's always got to be aware of the clock.
Got to know that,
right? That's got to be something. Got to be
another turnover for Will Mew. Cushing driving, spinning, shooting. Can't get it to fall, but Jacob Cushing getting to the free throw line. He's 4 of 4 this season from the line. And Jacob Cushing was not a guy that we saw do that a whole lot last year. Like to hang around the three-point line. He's really added the penetration to his game this year, trying to get to the line. He went to the line in just 3 of 22 games last year. So he played in 22 games, and just 3 of them he shot free throws. This is his third game in a row getting to the stripe.
I think that's a natural progression. I mean, you have a shooter. You do what you do well and are comfortable doing early. As you develop and mature as a player, you started adding elements to your game. And that's something he's got to be able to do so that he can, you know, definitely create a little bit more space for a shot as well.
Cushing makes good on both. Perfect on the season. An 11-0 run right now for Delaware over the last just over 3 minutes of basketball. Cushing shooting 50% from three on the year, coming off the bench as that third player behind Ithiel Horton and Matt Verretto. A take by Jermaine Head and the first points in the paint today for Will Mew. A good layup over Colin Gott.
That was the first time they've been able to successfully get into the lane and create an angle and finish there. Delaware's got to, you know, continue to keep him out of the.
Cushing will try from three, missing again. Same spot as he did earlier, 0 of 2 in this game today. Here's Jermaine Head. Bounce pass. Greenwich, he went for the highlight. Too strong on the dunk. And Head saved it to us. We're not participating. He maybe thought you had eligibility.
No, I would have probably either missed the shot or shanked it.
How about the dunk try, though, by Dawson Greenwich? Right. I like the effort there. Could come away with the dunk, but that would have been the play of the day.
Right. And, you know, the first time they got out in transition. You know, that's something that they wanted to do. That was one of their first opportunities.
Delaware, the basketball, 8:50 remaining, first half. They're going to give the basketball to Colin Goss, backing down his opponent. Fakes baseline, fades and hits. Colin Goss continuing to learn how to score with his back to the basket.
Yeah, that was good, you know, because he's a guy that likes to be outside on the perimeter. It was good to see him kind of use his footwork off the backboard for a soft jump shot.
Norwood's speaking of soft jump shots. He leans into one for the foul line. And now Will Mew trying to it looks like they've seemed to get into a little bit more of a rhythm offensively.
Yeah, it takes some time. You're playing against a little bit better opponent, so you got to figure out kind of what's going to be successful for you that night.
Cushing on the wing. Thought about a three, didn't take it. Up 24-10. Bounce pass baseline to Bryant. Bryant head fake. Wraparound pass to Colin Goss. Ball taken away by Jermaine Head, but a reach-in foul is going to be called against Will Mew. That'll be their fourth, down by 14.
Another thing is good to see Delaware, you know, on the season, only average about 13, something like assists a game.
Yeah, right around that area.
It's good. I think that they need to increase that, you know, maybe get that up to maybe 17, 18 assists. And it's good that they're doing a good job tonight, moving the ball, finding the open guy, and that guy stepping up and making some shots.
Well, Martin Inglesby is certainly a guy that knows how to dish it out.
Yeah.
He was one of the top assist men in the country back in 2001 when he was playing for Notre Dame. He averaged 6.4 assists per game for the Fighting Irish his senior year. 8 minutes left for Delaware in the first half. Up 14, 24-10. Johnson with it on the wing. Anderson driving in, kick out Johnson. He has 1-3 today. Can't find another with three on the shot clock. Rebound by Head. Head down the floor, inside out dribble to Greenwich. Greenwich to the newly inserted Alvin West, a local product from Smyrna, Delaware, and a St. Thomas More.
Delaware's D has been stout so far. You know, keeping all the lane except for one of the drives that they've had early.
High arcing three. Catch and release for Dawson Greenwich. He claps as he gets back on defense. He's feeling it right now.
He's right up the road. I know he has some fans in the stands. He pointed to somebody over here. Hope he wasn't pointing at me. I have no more eligibility left.
His cousin is playing right now in the NFL for the Jacksonville Jaguars. I think the Jags are on TV in our media room.
Oh, awesome.
Actually, if I'm not mistaken.
But
Dawson Greenwich, his cousin David Greenwich, went to Newark High School and now the tight end for the Jacksonville Jaguars. Dawson putting on a show at least here at the Bob Carpenter Center. After the three, it's 24-13, a whistle on the floor. Brings us to a timeout. 7:04 remaining in the first half. The Hens on top by 11.
I knew we
wouldn't get a good crowd today because it's Sunday. People are watching football.
Yeah.
It's Wilmington. Yeah.
Right.
Students are probably home for Thanksgiving.
Right.
Z-Quil Pure Z.
I mean, it's a matter of time. And it feels, it's kind of feeling like how we were. Like, you start building that momentum. You get some talent. Kids start playing well together. Bring a couple wins together. You'll start feeling a little bit more people on the stands.
The students came last year.
Did they?
Maybe you want, but it's Philadese.
That's more the community. Yeah.
Or the dependability of Chevy Silverado 1500.
But certainly today it's hard. We're playing a D2 squad on Sunday.
Of Chevy Silverado HD. Check, and
I think the Eagles play at 4, right?
Chevy truck you choose.
4 o'clock.
Yeah. No wrong answer. Checkmate. Chevrolet.
A lot of Mad Eagles saying. Doing too well.
Yeah. No. Here we go. Super Bowl hangover.
On 94.7 WDSD and iHeartRadio.
Buying a new or new to you vehicle should be a fun, rewarding experience, and it was for me thanks to Matthew Kersey, president of Chevrolet of Dover. I experienced the Dover difference at Chevrolet of Dover, and I was able to buy my vehicle the way I wanted with a great deal with every possible discount they could find. Find new roads, visit ChevroletofDover.com. I'm Scott Clapson alongside Ty Perry. Benny Pinella producing today. He'll be our halftime host as well. Delaware up 24-13 here at the Bob Carpenter Center, shooting 50% from the field, while Wilmington just 28%. The Hens led in scoring thus far by Eric Carter and Colin Goss. 6 for Carter, 5 for Colin Goss. The big men doing it so far for the Hens. Anderson, one of the guards, making his second three-pointer of the game. He's up to 6 points as well.
He makes the game look so easy.
He is very talented. He can be silky smooth at times. He really can. Delaware missed out on his freshman year, playing just 11 games. Didn't get to redshirt. If he played 10 games, he would have got the redshirt. But playing an 11th game put him over that 30% mark. As Wilmington University misses on a fadeaway jump shot on the left side. Delaware the rebound, up 27-13. Here's Anderson. Johnson, a touch pass into Carter. Double team comes. Kick out to Anderson. Anderson drives the lane. Floats one up and hits. 5 in a row for Anderson.
That's good. You know, Delaware is going to be really successful when you have them two working in a tandem. You know, with Carter, Anderson, in and out. That was, you know, good, nice little flow there.
You made the comment a moment ago. He makes it look easy sometimes. Yeah, he really does make it look like it's effortless at times for Kevin Anderson, averaging 16.5 points per game, a 3 off the hands of Jordan Harding. He's missed twice from long range, 29-13. Delaware's lead, 6 minutes left in the first half. Cushing bounces it inside to Carter, but it's stolen away by Harding. Harding then loses it. Carter with the steal, and now Harding trying to get the basketball back. Reached in, fouled Eric Carter. That's a 6th foul on Wilmington. Next, we'll put Delaware in the 1-1.
Cushing, you know, with a bigger guy playing against a smaller defender, you might want to throw that ball up right at his face, throw it high so he can just kind of go up and get it, put it on the floor. It gives the little guy a little bit more of an advantage to get to the ball.
And he was kind of staring at Carter as he brought the pass in, allowing Wilmington back door. Anderson to Johnson. As I'm chatting away, Anderson wasted no time to get the play back in action and finding the cutter. And Anderson, good look. Greenwich, he's had a quick trigger last couple possessions, decides not to shoot the three over Anderson. Here's West corner, it's Greenwich. Greenwich for Wilmu. Leading scorer with 6 points on 2 of 2 from three-point range. 31-13, Delaware's lead. Norwood straight away three, missing into the hands of Darian Bryant for Delaware. Eyes up the court. Pushes to Horton. Horton a three from the corner right side. Another triple down for the Blue Hens. They've made 6 today.
Well, Delaware's really shooting the ball well from the outside. They're getting it from inside out. Transition threes off the dribble.
43% from long range today in this first half for the Blue Hens. We played 15 minutes of basketball here at the Bob Carpenter Center. Greenwich for the foul line. Kick out to West. West, bad spacing. Gives it to Norwood in the corner. He'll reset with 10. Inside, the ball goes to Harding. Harding, a pump fake, gets Carter in the air. That's a good take by the young man, Jordan Harding from Bear, Delaware.
Yeah, just before that move and that score inside, Delaware has done a really good job of eliminating anything around the basket. They're switching on the perimeter. I'm impressed with Delaware defensive effort so far this game. And, you know, obviously, you know, you're looking at how they, well, they're shooting the ball, but I think defensively they're really taking the Wilmington out of what they want to do offensively.
Harding, 6'5" freshman, 4-year letter winner at William Penn High School, played for Steven Christensen, head coach at William Penn, makes the free throw, 34-16. 4:41, and Davis Long into the game for the first time today, the freshman walk-on.
Right.
From Sherwood High School. He had 8 points against Chestnut Hill coming off the bench. That's Coach Higgins will be saying, we don't think of him as a walk-on. He's a good ball player.
Yeah, that's great, man. Freshman walk-on in the game, or in the first half against, you know, a team. That's awesome for him, man.
Johnson drives, missing a contested layup, slicing right to left. Now he's got to get back on defense as Wilmu pushing a bit as we approach the 4-minute mark. Norwood, dribble, handoff, head, step back, high arcing, three on the way, a miss. In the hands of Carter. Carter and Johnson, miscommunication. As Johnson tipped it out of Carter's hands, it'll stay with Will Mew.
Yeah, just a little communication there. Great challenge by Bryant on Norwood's three. I mean, it's really taking him out of his game. He's making him more of a shooter. He's more of a go-to-the-basket, get-to-the-basket type of player. That kind of gets him going.
Greenwich had a good look at a three there, missing for the first time from long range in the hands of Verretto for Delaware. Anderson bounced pass to Carter. Carter guarded by the 5'9 Norwood, and he missed. That's a win for Norwood defensively.
Right. Yeah.
5'9 Norwood pushed Carter off his block, and they'll have fun with that in film study, I'm sure, tomorrow. Greenwich, 15-foot jump shot. He's got a good-looking shot. Missed there, though, to Bryant.
Yeah, he's, I don't think he knew he was going to be that wide open. he turned around. Nobody was there.
I'm laughing at the last possession still.
Norwood.
I can laugh because Carter's had such a great start to his year. He's shooting 70%. It's a rare miss as it is. 34-16 the score. Long. He'll let it fly from three. Couldn't get the bounce. It sat on the rim and rolled off into the hands of the Wildcats. Danny Walsh guarded by Long, the William Penn graduate. Over to Harding. Harding made a bucket inside, probably where he should go get back to. He's 0-3 from three after that miss.
Yeah. Ryan does a little bit of everything. He initiates the offense, defends the best players, one of the toughest kids on the team, plays through injury.
He said he's feeling healthier than he ever has this year as Carter goes inside and works over Greenwich that time to his right hand. Beautiful take by Eric Carter over the 6'5", Dawson Greenwich.
Yeah, he has really good footwork, nice touch around the basket.
And he's worked his career, and it's really paying dividends this year as a senior.
And he's been able to score on both blocks. I thought last year he kind of was on the right side a lot. On there, on the left block, he's done a add stuff to his game.
Norwood missed on one end. Delaware comes back. 2:23. First half of basketball. Hens up 36-16. Going to have to do some work on the offensive end if they want to get to 100 like they did on Tuesday against Chestnut Hill.
I was taking the under on that.
Verretto stolen away by ahead and ahead of the pack is Jermaine, the redshirt sophomore. A timeout taken by Martin Inglesby. We'll take a break with him. Martin Inglesby not pleased with Matt Verretto and his team right now. Just too many turnovers, five on the day. They still lead 36-18. Always got to be coaching. We'll be back in a moment.
Always.
American Spirit Federal Credit Union now offers free Casasa checking. With free Casasa
checking,
you earn 4% cash back on everyday debit purchases with no category restrictions.
Young guy,
4% cash back paid each month.
He's going to be one of those scrappy. You guys have a guy on a team, like a scrappy guy that was just like dive for balls, grab off.
Go to AmericanSpirit.org or visit any American Spirit Federal Credit Union location in Newark, Middletown, and Dover and ask for free Casasa checking. That's AmericanSpirit.org.
Speedy Claxton.
This is the
everybody's
country.
We're back.
94.7 WDSD.
Welcome back here to the Bob Carpenter Center. 2:06 to play in the first half. 36-18 is the score, and the Delaware Blue Hens on top of Wilmington University. Kevin Anderson with 8 points, 8 for Carter, 5 points for Goss, 5 for Johnson, 5 for Horton, and had to go down the box score here.
25.
As
54.
Greenwich leads Wilmington University. I had to stall for time here. The official coming
up.
Everybody here, Ty.
The official's coming. No, he wanted to see the shooting percentage. I don't know if he wants to try to balance
He's
it.
Trying to balance
we need to
get, did we just help him? The official change this game a little bit?
Right.
Evan Burroughs.
I don't know how that's going
to
help.
Coming over to say hello. just to get a minute of your time when we're not on the air. It's difficult. Everyone, and rightfully so, a legend in this building, Ty Perry, a two-time conference champion. But it must be nice to walk in and everybody wants to say hello.
It's nice, man. It's been a long time, and we have a lot of guys that are still around. So it's good to, say hello.
Cushing rattles in a three for the corner. He missed his first two, stuck with it, and knocks down what is his ninth three-pointer of the season. A nice job by Jacob Cushing. Really working on a shot in the offseason and really paying dividends this year as a junior from Naperville, Illinois. On the defensive side, Greenwich goes inside, uses the left, misses to get enough on it to go above the rim. And now Davis Long trying to lead Matt Verretto down the floor, stolen away by Norwood, who got back on defense. Harding to the rim, draws contact, but it's an offensive foul.
There you go.
Anderson took the charge.
Yeah. You know, it's great to see as a Delaware alum, the talent, the depth of talent. You,
young talent Delaware has. I mean, they keep coming off the bench with kids that are skilled, that can shoot the ball and handle the ball and make good decisions. So
that's something that plagued Delaware last year with all of the injuries, guys banged up. They just didn't have guys to go to off the bench. And sometimes players just need a break. Kevin Anderson rarely does as he gets inside. And he's got double figures now, 10 points with the layup. But the more depth you have, the more availability when players get in foul trouble and if guys need blows. Here's Walsh in the corner. Grinage has been the go-to guy in the first half for Wilmington. Fades and hits over Reto. Dawson Grinage, really impressive for the Wildcats.
Yeah, Dawson, he's a good player. I remember seeing him playing. I think he played. Did he play
William Penn.
William Penn, yes. Seeing him playing in high school, man. He's a really, really came into his own his senior year.
Good ball player. Yeah. 8 points out of Wilmington's 20 in the first half. It's 41-20. About 8 seconds differentiating the game clock and the shot clock, so the Hens will have to get one off with seven. Now Anderson with five. Ooh. He gets his pocket picked by Dawson Grinage. It's 2-on-1. Grinage will keep it himself, missing the layup. 7 seconds to work with for Delaware. Davis Long ahead to Bryant. 4 seconds for Delaware. 2 seconds for Bryant. Ooh. Gets to the rim with one at the buzzer. Darian Bryant to the cup and scoring. He out the basketball at half court with about 4 seconds. Great take by Darian Bryant.
Yeah, I thought he was going to settle for a three. That was a good move, crossover, little jab step, go in there, finish with the left hand.
Good to know his own talents, to know how quickly he gets to the basket, got to the rim and scored with tenths of seconds left on the clock. 43-20 is the score at the half. We'll take a timeout. We come back. It's the IBEW, Local 313 halftime report. We'll send it back to the studio and Benny Pinella. Back in a moment on 94.7 WDSD.
Hey, it's Scott Klatskin, voice of the Blue Hens, and when my family needed to purchase a new vehicle, we chose Chevrolet of Dover. The Chevy Equinox has everything we need, from style and technology to performance and safety. This versatile crossover offers us the complete package. But even more so, Chevrolet of Dover offered the complete package. From the time I walked through the door, owner Matt made me feel comfortable and helped me find the right vehicle for my family. Do what I did and visit ChevroletOfDover.com. Chevrolet of Dover, find new roads.
Just For You is taking over for My Mix at Acme, and it's making saving even easier. You'll find more ways to redeem rewards for savings on gas or groceries. Just For You, available on the Acme app. This week, Lancaster brand USDA Choice Beef Petite Sirloin Steaks are buy one, get two free. And Juicy Halo's California Mandarins 5-pound box, only $4.99. Restrictions and exclusions apply. For complete details, go to acmemarkets.com/rewards.
At Kia Sarah, we see your company differently. We see your documents, how they are accessed, what it takes to keep them secure, and how well your workflow is flowing. Companies throughout the region choose Kia Sarah and Excel Business Systems. Want your entire document infrastructure to run more efficiently and cost-effectively? Listen to the experts at Excel Business Systems.
Schedule your free assessment today with Excel Business Systems. 302-453-1500.
Welcome to the Blue Hens Halftime Report, presented by the International Brotherhood of Electrical Workers, Local 313, and its local contractors.
Welcome to the IBEW Local 313 Halftime Show. Delaware dominating at the half over Wilmington by a score of 43-20. And Delaware taking it to the Division II Wildcats right now. Kevin Anderson leads the Hens in scoring. He's got 10 points on 4 of 5, 2 of 3 from beyond the arc. He's got 3 assists and 2 rebounds ahead of Delaware. Eric Carter thought he was going to have a big game. He's got 6 rebounds so far and 8 points, working on a double-double. Very well could have that fairly soon coming into the second half. Again, the tallest player from Wilmington area, Scott Klatskin, alluded in the Wilmington. Tallest player is only 6'5 in this game, so Delaware certainly has the height advantage with Eric Carter. Other scoring for Delaware, Goss, Johnson, and Jacob Cushing, all with 5 points in this game. So far, the scoring leader for Wilmington has been Dawson Grinage. He has 8 points for the Wildcats. He is 3 of 8 from the field, 2 of 3 from beyond the arc. Once again, Delaware up 43-20 at the half. Other CAA games in action right now. 4 minutes left in the first half. UNCW dominating over Allen University, 42-28. Ty Gadsden, 12 points there. Devontae Kaycock, he has 7 points, but he's only 3 of 7 from the free throw line. He's got to improve those numbers as the season progresses right there. So UNCW handling Allen University fairly easy. Bigger getting handled. Towson manhandled by North Dakota State, 76-51. The game really was never that close. North Dakota State led in scoring. The three players who had double digits, 13 for Geyu, and then Terrell Ely, who had 14 points, and Terrell Ward had 11 points for Bison. For Towson, only one player getting into double digits. That would have been Ryan Forbes. He had 12 points in that game. Other CAA contests that will go down today. We will also see Charleston versus Oklahoma State at 4 p.m. So that game still a couple of hours, an hour, a couple minutes away from tip-off in Northeastern. Versus Davidson, a 6 p.m. game for Charleston. In the NCAA Top 25, Michigan and Providence locked in a game right now. It's starting to go the way of the Wolverines after Providence kept it close at the half, 35-22. Now it's up to 44-29. So that is your look at the top five scores in the world of basketball. Of course, at 6 p.m., VMI will be on the road to take on Kentucky, number 10. The Wildcats of Kentucky. Texas Tech will face the Spartans of Michigan State, 11th-ranked Michigan State at 6 p.m. 7:30, number 12, Kansas State will face Penn, and a 16-23 matchup. Virginia Tech will face Purdue. That one from Charleston, South Carolina. We have more scores and stats for you coming up in the post-game show. Delaware again, 43-20 over Wilmington at the half. We'll take a quick break. When we come back, we have your Blue Hen Sports Report, which includes a bracket breakdown of the football program. Yeah, they are in the postseason, so we'll talk a little bit about that. We'll talk about the renovations getting done to the new football stadium and women's basketball. They're coming off a win. We'll talk about that and, of course, their next game. It's all coming up on the IBEW Local 313 Halftime Show on 94.7 WTSD.
Howdy, folks. Colonel Sanders here with a super important holiday message from KFC. No more gifts. Your family and friends just want you to buy them one of my KFC $5 fill-ups. They're packed full of Kentucky Fried Chicken, mashed potatoes, a biscuit, cookie, and a drink. It's the thought that counts, and the thought is that they're hungry. KFC, it's finger-licking good. Prices and participation may vary. Tax and substitutions extra.
Delaware attorney William Earhart offers practical legal solutions on estate and elder services and is here to help you. Contact estateandelderlawservices.com today.
This is Dr. Michael Axe of First Aid Orthopedics, the team of top docs taking care of Delaware from the beach to the bridge and beyond. If you have shoulder or knee pain or a condition in another body region, please call us for an appointment at one of our 12 statewide locations. We treat muscle, tendon, bone, or joint ailments from your neck to your toes with the latest techniques to include PRP and stem cells. For more FSO information, go to our website, firstaidortho.com. You can also Twitter with our physicians and staff, but you should Facebook with us, especially on Patient Testimonial Tuesdays. First Aid Orthopedics, the team of top docs taking care of Delaware from the beach to the bridge and beyond.
Get behind the wheel of a Chevrolet, you're driving dependability year in and year out. Check out the entire award-winning lineup at ChevyDealer.com.
Klondike Cades on Main Street in Newark is the proud home of the Blue Hens Basketball Coaches Show. Join coaches Martin Inglesby and Natasha Adair at Cades on Monday, November 19th at 7 p.m.
You're listening to the Blue Hens Halftime Report, presented by the International Brotherhood of Electrical Workers Local 313 and its local contractors.
And welcome back to the IBEW Local 313 Halftime Show. Delaware up on the Wildcats of Wilmington by a score of 43-20 at the half. It's time now for your Blue Hens Sports Reports. And the Delaware women's basketball team, they're coming off a win over Nicholls State by a score of 71-56. Abby Gonzalez led the Hens in scoring, 20 points. Jasmine Dickey had 15. She had off to a solid start in her freshman campaign. Simone DeFries with 12 points. And Justina Ascara with 10 to pace the Hens to a 71-56 victory over Nicholls. Next up for the Delaware Blue Hens, they will travel downstate about an hour to Dover. A game that you will hear against the Delaware State Hornets on Tuesday at 6 p.m. A game you can hear on our sister stations, Fox Sports 1290 AM and 1410 WDOV. The next home game won't be until December. They'll face and host a
Say, can you see 2 million bucks?
Lotto America is the new drawing game that's sweeping the nation. Get six numbers right, including the star ball, and you win. And with jackpots starting at $2 million, you win big. Lotto America from the Delaware Lottery. It's the new way to play and win the American dream.
So you guys have recently started dating?
Yes.
A little less than a month.
Coming up on 2 months now, yeah.
Cool. I want to show you guys these three Chevy SUVs. The first one is called the Trax.
Beautiful.
Do you think it would be good for moving in together?
Moving in together?
Okay. Well, this is the Chevy Equinox.
Wow.
Nice.
Perfect for when you two have your first kid.
Yeah, so tired.
Okay. This is the Traverse for when you have your five kids, two dogs, and one cat.
Oh. Five?
Well, no matter what stage of life you're in, Chevy has an SUV for you.
We have it all planned out. Thanks.
Welcome back to Fightin' Blue Hens Basketball on 94.7 WDSD and iHeartRadio.
Welcome back into the Bob Carpenter Center. I'm Scott Clapton alongside Ty Perry. And a big thanks to Benny Pinella for taking care of our IBEW Local 313 halftime report. At the Bob Carpenter Center, Delaware leads 43-20 at the break. Remind our listeners that at Dash In, you can get any size coffee or cappuccino for only 99 cents, made with 100% Arabica beans. Their coffees are bold, smooth, and rich. Fall in love at first sip with Dash In coffee, any size, for only 99 cents. Find a location near you at dashin.com. Before we get into first half stats of time, just your overall thoughts on the first 20 minutes of hoops.
Overall, I thought Delaware started really well, you know, with their keys of keeping them out of the paint, challenging shots. I think the offensively for Delaware, they just got in the flow. They're shooting the ball well from behind the arc. I think Eric Carter has kind of asserted himself, been able to go inside out. I just, you know, for Delaware, I really like the depth, you know, and, you know, you see those guys come off the bench and doesn't have, you don't miss a beat. You know, you have a guy that's got very similar skills as the starters, whereas for Wilmington, I think, you know, I think I want to see them play a little bit faster. I think when you play slow, I guess a bigger team. You can see the size disparity. If they can kind of get up and get up and down, I think that'll help. And maybe try to get to the basket a little bit and put some pressure off the dribble against Delaware guards. But Delaware has done a good job of keeping them in front.
You make a good point. We saw a couple times when Will Mew was able to get out and run a little bit and help them out when they've been in that half court set. Delaware just a little bigger, faster, stronger for them. You'll find that with a Division I team taking on a D2 squad as Wilmington is. Let's take a look inside the box score, and you talk about the depth, Ty. Everybody except for Davis Long, who has appeared in the game, has scored for Delaware.
Yeah.
Kevin Anderson, 10 points on 4 of 5 shooting. He's 2 of 3 from long range. 8 points for Eric Carter, who's 4 of 5, along with 6 rebounds for Eric, leading the team in that category. And then 4 guys have 5 points. Cushing, Horton, Johnson, and Goss, all with 5 points. Darian Bryant with 2 points that came at the buzzer, but he's got 5 rebounds and 3 assists. No turnovers for Darian Bryant, and he's also been guarding Jermaine Head and Dawson Grinage, two of the top scorers on Wilmu. For Delaware, they're shooting 59% from the field, 44% from 3. For Wilmu, 8 points for Dawson Grinage, 5 points for Jermaine Head, 3 for Jordan Harding, 2 points for Norwood and Walsh, playing but not scoring, Haynes and West. Wilmington on the other side of things, shooting just 26% from the field. They are 14% from 3, 2 of 14. Delaware having the advantage in almost every statistical category. Turnovers, though, Delaware has turned the basketball over 7 times. And we saw Coach Inglesby call a timeout at one point, telling his team, got to take care of the basketball. Otherwise, that's the only blemish, really, on Delaware's resume in the first 20 minutes.
Yeah, but, even with the turnovers, they had 3 early in the beginning of the game and then settled in and only had 4 the rest of the half. I like that they have 10 assists to 7 turnovers. I think that they've kind of been on the other side in previous games. One very positive, glaring stat is they have 23 rebounds to Wilmington 13 rebounds. They're really dominating, only giving them 1 shot per possession. And they're also getting to the offensive glass a little as well. So they can continue to do that in the second half. They have a pretty good second half here.
Starters back on the floor for Delaware to start the second half. They'll defend as well, but you goes left to right as we see it. Bryant, Anderson, Johnson, the guards, Goss, and Carter, the bigs for Delaware. Norwood, Haynes, Head, Walsh, and Grinnins to start for the Wildcats. First possession of the second half, Head dribbles inside, sees Bryant and Goss, and thinks twice of his penetration, brings it back out to Norwood. 12 to shoot for Grinnins, now it's Head. 25 points per game on the year, and Head was held up on his drive. A foul going to be called, I believe, against Darian Bryant. Darian was thinking, who, me? I didn't see it. Darian was confused a bit, but a quick whistle.
It was a quick whistle. But that was one of the things I think key is trying to get to the paint. And I did a good job of ball screening and trying to turn the corner and get into the lane.
Reset.
Aggressive off the ball screen.
After the foul on the shot clock, his Head gets to Grinnage. Goss in the air. Grinnage to the rim. Tried to poster Eric Carter. Poor Dawson Grinnage. That's the second time he's missed a dunk in this basketball game. But I like the effort.
Right. You got to like the effort, man. He's going in there against a 6'11", 7-footer. And trying to finish over top of him. He's really excited, got a lot of energy. Good play, good fella. He'll finish the next one.
Show of mine, I enjoyed, said, you come at the king, you best not miss.
Right.
Dawson Grinnage has missed twice on those dunks. Eric Carter saves a wild passer going out of bounds, and his save then goes back court. So a little sloppy play to start this second half. A foul on the reach in and a turnover. Right. Can't be pleasing to Martin Inglesby, as his team is still up 43-20, but you want to play precise basketball the rest of the way.
Yeah, it's always good to start the game. The first 4 minutes of the half is important to come out, be focused, and execute. Do it lackadaisical with the ball early on.
19:04, just getting started in the second half, as Norwood has had a tough day. Just 2 points, 1 of 6 from the field, guarded closely by Kevin Anderson. Passes to Head, Head shot over of Eric Carter. He misses. Goss with a rebound. Now Anderson pushing to Bryant in the corner. Dribble presentation back to Anderson. Anderson a pass to Goss. Goss working around the perimeter. Squaring. Firing on a 3 is Bryant. He's short on the triple. Norwood wants to run. That's what we thought we might see
right
from Wilmu.
Yeah.
Pushing the basketball. Haynes, foul line, jump shot wide open. Clangs it off the back of the iron into the hands of Darian Bryant. That's rebound number 6 for Jelly.
I think Coach Burke is really, probably pleased with that possession, even though he missed a shot, pushing it up the floor, getting an open look there at the foul line.
Good look for the transfer from Northern Oklahoma Community College. Eric Carter straight away. He's made a 3 this year. His first of his career against Maryland. He thought about it. Said Anderson will take one from the same spot. and a miss from Kevin Anderson, who's made two today on four tries.
Delaware was really shooting the ball to high rep from three first half. Missed a few here, kind of get back in the flow.
Stuck at 43 is Delaware in the second half. His head missed on an extended foul line, jump shot right side of the floor. Back to Delaware it goes. 17-48, second half as Bryant comes across the lane. Over to Johnson, back on top to Darian. Darian inside, float shot off the backboard and off the mark. A rebound by Dawson Greenwich for the Wildcats.
I would like to see Delaware go inside to Eric. Just to kind of initiate the offense, settle one down a little bit.
That's how they start the first half of every basketball game.
Yeah.
And a pass in the corner. Greenwich has had a hot hand in the first half. Can't stay that way with a miss from the corner in the second half here. Delaware has not scored in the first 2.5 minutes.
I think Coach Inglesby recognizing it's going to do a set play. Generally, they do this play. They run it for Carr to come off a diagonal screen and get him inside.
Johnson. They give it to Carter. Okay. Screen set on Anderson. Anderson in the paint. Back out to Johnson. Johnson, good look at a three, but another miss. Back tapped by Carter, but it's Norwood who comes away with it. Delaware still yet to score. We're 3 minutes into the second half, 43-20. Hopes to get to 100, diminishing by the second here. Although that, I say that playfully, that's certainly not one of the goals for Delaware. But they want to execute a little bit better offensively. Right. Will Muse look good in the second half. There's a foul drawn on Colin Goss. It'll send Haynes to the free throw line. A chance to get him on the board. He's scoreless on four shots.
Although Wilmington hasn't scored, either team, but I think Wilmington's playing to their strengths. They're pushing the ball off the floor. They're a little bit attacking the basket. And I think this is how they really wanted to start the game. But they're kind of getting into their game plan now.
Haynes is 6'6", listed as the tallest player on the University, or Wilmington University's team. Double figures in each game this season. He had 14 in the opener at St. Thomas Aquinas, but his first point there from the free throw line. From Brooklyn, New York, Denzel Haynes had a double-double earlier in the year. 14-point, 15-rebound performance in his debut.
I can see that. I mean, he's got curve, size, good touch. At a Division II level, I can see him being really successful.
I agree with you. Makes both free throws. He looks like a guy that can perform against guys his size.
Yeah, exactly.
A little tougher against Colin Goss and Eric Carter today. 43-22 after the free throws. Ethiel Horton into the game. Colin Goss to the bench. Derry Bryant around a defender, and Bryant will see if he can get on the board for Delaware from the free throw line as he draws contact.
And Coach really likes this small lineup. I think you talked about that earlier. I think it just gives them a little bit more energy and flexibility and durability with being able to stretch the floor and be able to get four guys that can go off the dribble, great dribble penetration to get to the basket.
Sometimes I'm surprised that there's a big in there at all, the way Martin Inglesby likes to get up and down the floor. He would love for these guys to just let it fly and run and gun, and they're able to do that with this lineup. One big in the middle to Eric Carter, and certainly when Ryan Allen gets back, they'll be able to make some adjustments, and going to have a lot of guys just to score the basketball around Eric Carter. It's going to be a good-looking team. Not that it isn't right now, but it's going to be even better Allen gets off crutches.
Yeah, that would be nice to see him when he gets back in.
First point on the board for Delaware in the second half is making one of two, went Darian Bryant. Bryant, 3 points on the day, 1 of 4 shooting. Here's Norwood, 15 to shoot. He brings it back out between the circles. Carter defending him. Norwood knows he has a mismatch. NBA range three off the mark into the hands of Anderson for Delaware.
I know Coach probably wanted Norwood to try to attack the basket against a bigger guy instead of settling for a deep three there.
Bryant settling on the other end for a three. And the Hens field goal percentage in this half still at 0, 0 of 5 in this second frame. 44-22. Walsh taking it to the rim and around Darian Bryant using the right hand. Outstretched arms of Bryant couldn't block it. And Danny Walsh gets the score.
Yeah, again, if Wilmington would start the game like this, it would probably be a little bit closer. They're doing a good job of getting to the basket, putting pressure on the Delaware's defense.
Wilmington outscoring Delaware 4-1 in the first almost 5 minutes of action as a rare miss close to the rim from Eric Carter comes off. Dawson Greenwich on the other end. Wilmington missing on a three. That was halfway down. Good look again by Dawson Greenwich, who's 3 of 11 today, 8 points.
Yeah, it's always hard to count it when you're up and come back in the second half and be focused. Delaware is showing a little immaturity not being.
You're right, and a turnover there is Wilmington.
Yeah.
Trying to add to their total. Walsh as the tank should dribble. Back out to Norwood. Two little guys on the floor. Walsh at 5'11", 5'9", stands Norwood. Up and under move. Head can't finish, but a great take by the sophomore. Here's Bryant ahead of the pack in front of the Delaware bench. Back out to Horton. 14:40. We'll take a break at the next whistle as Anderson brings it back out to Horton. Horton, the freshman, will run the offense.
I don't think Delaware has recognized Carter has head on him. Well, I think they switched now.
Now they switch it, but you're right, he did. As Bryant will line up a three. That one's short. Delaware been short on their jump shots in this half. 0 of 7 to start the second half of basketball. Norwood will let a three fly, corner off the mark. Good offensive rebound by Haynes, and Haynes showing some toughness, gets it up and in. And Delaware being outscored 6-1 in the first 6 minutes of basketball.
Yeah. Delaware just got to get back, lock back in.
0-7 from the field, and a foul called against Will Mew trying to defend Eric Carter. He'll be able to go to the free throw line, and Martin Ingles will be able to talk to his team, settle him down a little bit perhaps here in the second half. Delaware's secure lead right now with 44-26 on top of Will Mew. We'll take a break with 13:55 remaining in the second half of basketball.
Sometimes you can get three happy, you know. They made some shots. I don't know if they and characteristically.
I mean, do you come out and just kind of like, we already won?
It's hard. I mean, you got a young team. They did a good job of going inside out, getting those open looks. I think they've shot some quick threes in the start of this half, and, you know, just get back to do what they do well, is inside out, into the basket.
You're right, 0 of 5 from 3 out of 7 shots, 5 of them from long range in this half, and Eric Carter will go to the free throw line. Carter makes the free throw. First make of the day from the line, his second visit. He missed his first two. He's got 9 points now. And Carter's second free throw rolls in. Double figures for Carter. He joins Kevin Anderson as the only two to hit double digits so far today. A little full court pressure we're seeing here from Delaware.
Yeah, coach is just trying to, you know, just kind of get his guys into it, you know, lock them in, you know, speed the game up some. That was a good change for coach. I think that's a good strategy move.
Head over to Greenwich. Greenwich back to Head. Head penetrating on Ithiel Horton. Solid defense by Ithiel, and Head just lost it on his way up and out of bounds. We've got a visitor here, Ty.
Yeah,
we got UD.
Baby UD, right?
Baby UD.
Good to see you. Yeah.
I don't think the mascot realizes we're on the radio.
I know.
Maybe no one
you
can,
talk?
Can see us. But we appreciate the visit.
Right.
We'll get back to calling the game. I'll give you the headset maybe at the next commercial break.
Right.
We appreciate the visit. Horton, foul line jump shot. That's off the mark. Delaware still yet to make a shot from the field. I thought Baby Blue would be able to maybe help out, but she did not. Even the mascots love to see it.
I think they came over to see you there.
I've been doing this since Dawson Greenwich misses on a foul line jump shot rebound Kevin Anderson. I've been doing this for 7 years now. I don't think Baby Blue has came over to visit
Has never come over to visit.
Just one time. Not once. But today I'm with Ty Perry, two-time champion here at Delaware, and we get all the love.
Yeah.
I would have had John Boyd earlier if I knew all the
I know you get a lot of that. I think it's you, though. I think it's definitely you.
Having a good time, good crowd out here on a Sunday, and thank you for listening with us, spending some of your Sunday with 94.7 WDSD and the iHeartRadio app. But Delaware defending now against Wilmington University, 46-26, their lead, 12:44, second half. And the Hens 0-8 to start this second half of basketball from the field. Head turns it over for the second straight time, driving in the lane.
Yeah.
Just losing grip.
It's good to see Coach Steve Steinwettel, one of the two-time champion back in the early 90s, sitting in the stands. Delaware is starting to pull those guys back into the fold a little bit as the team continues to get better.
That's right. He's here. Carter working inside. There's the first bucket from the field in the second half. You need a hoop. Go to Eric Carter, number 5 on the block, and he's got 12.
Yeah, just go play through him. Just play through him right now. When you need a basket, that's good to see.
48-26 after the make by Carter. He's got 12 points, 6 rebounds, averaging 20 and 9.5. Backdoor pass Norwood. Good idea. Tight window to slip it into Harding, and a turnover for Wilmington.
I thought Wilmington started to have up-tempo a little bit. Now they've kind of slowed it, and Delaware's defense is really stout. It's going to be hard for them to score in the half court against Delaware. I think they need to try to push the tempo some.
Wilmington, 2-3 turnovers for the last 2 minutes of basketball. They have not scored during that stretch. Cushing inside to Carter. Here we go again, working from Carter, passing to Horton. Horton driving to the rim, getting all the way to the cup. He was at the foul line. No one stopped the ball, and he got to the rim. Another basket from Ithiel Horton.
I know Coach Burke's probably upset. That's, drive from the perimeter into the lane without anybody stepping up.
Walsh a shot over Eric Carter, who came out to contest, is a miss. 11:32, second half, pass, no look inside to Carter. A head fake, a double team, a pass out to Horton, and Ithiel Horton from the corner can't connect. Good look at a three that time. And Eric Carter continues to pass well out of that double team. Yep. It's Greenwich to Walsh. Walsh from the wing left side. Slingshot three, a miss. Ahead of the pack is Verretto. Verretto slicing through right to left, and the lefty.
Lefty
strong, 5 points for Verretto off the bench.
Yeah, he's a scorer. He finds ways to score, and I like the young guy, left hand.
Does a little bit of everything.
Yeah,
like that energy off the bench, Matt Verretto bringing in his freshman campaign. 6'7", 210 out of Connecticut. Now Verretto gets it back. Good pass by Anderson. Head fake, and Verretto, 4 in a row.
They got going back to Carter, kind of seeing the ball go through the hole. Now they've scored a couple in transition now.
A 10-0 run by Delaware. Last 3 minutes of action, 54-26. We're about halfway through this second half here at the Bob Carpenter Center. Will Mew coming down the road to the Bob Carpenter Center. Final Division II game of the year for Delaware. They beat Chestnut Hill, who plays in the same conference as Will Mew, on Tuesday. Greenwich, float shot missing into the Hayes of Eric Carter. Carter 7 rebounds. Anderson has 7 rebounds. Anderson rebounds very well. A point guard averaging 7.5 rebounds per game. That's an impressive stat line as Carter gets the ball knocked out of his hands, gets it back to Anderson. Cross court pass to Horton. Horton will drive inside, stripped.
Yeah.
And a whistle is going to be called against Wilmington University. That'll send us to a timeout. 9:57 left to play. Delaware in control of this one. 54-26 is the count for the Bob Carpenter Center.
Chevrolet of Dover, the best deals, best selection, and a free lifetime warranty. Chevrolet of Dover, where you get treated like family. Find new roads
at Chevrolet.
Yeah, it's tough. In Mark's, this is Inglesby, third year, right? You see that,
Say, can you see 2 million bucks?
Lotto America is the new drawing game that's sweeping the nation. Get 6 numbers right, including the star ball, and you win. And with jackpots starting at $2 million, you win big. Lotto America from the Delaware Lottery. It's the new way to play and win the American dream.
Hors d'oeuvres, fresh seafood, turkey, fresh fruits and veggies, and don't forget
the
dessert.
So the two guys that are talking there, one in the dark suit, one in the light suit, what are their roles?
Operations and like video coordinator. We're back here.
WDSD.
Welcome back here to the Bob Carpenter Center. Delaware up 54-26. Heads on a 10-0 run over the last 4 minutes of basketball. Looking inside the box score, 12 for Eric Carter, 10 for Kevin Anderson, 7 for Horton, 7 for Verretto. Johnson and Goss with 5, as well as Cushing. 3 points for Bryant, and Long has played has not scored yet. They've got the half-court toss in front of us, Ty. That $1,000 is mine.
Right.
You give me one shot out there.
It's going in. All right.
The shot that we just saw in front of us, it didn't make the three-point line.
I thought she was throwing a pass.
Yeah.
I thought she was throwing
Maybe
a pass.
Maybe she thought
there.
She, as far as she could throw it, then she get to shoot it from that point.
That sounds about right.
I don't know. But Delaware, they've been shooting not as well as they'd like to in the second half. 4 of 13 in the second half after shooting above 50% in the first. But you mentioned it. They went back inside to Eric Carter a couple times, and that allowed some more rhythm on the offensive side.
Right. You know. And I think once they realize that, that's going to happen throughout the year, too. If they struggle some, it's understanding where their bread and butter is. You know, he's really talented. He's done a good job of going inside out and not forcing shots as well.
Ethiel Horton at the free throw line. Good looking freshman. He's got 9 after 2 free throws. Ethiel Horton has his team up 56-26. Horton has scored double figures in three of his first 4 college basketball games. And on his way there again if he can get another. 9:41 left. Newly inserted player. For the first time, we see Corey Gordon. His head shoots on a 3, misses. Grinch tries to tap to his teammate. It comes to Colin Goss. So Delaware's going to run a bit. Ethiel Horton, now left side of the floor. Gets to the rim, draws contact, no whistle. Tipped by Goss after the miss. That doesn't fall. Norwood now on the run to head. Head has Gordon to his right side. Gordon driving baseline, reaching foul by Matt Verretto. As Corey Gordon tries to get into the action. He's played 1 game this year, scored 2 points. A redshirt freshman from St. Thomas More. Dover, Delaware native.
Delaware went to a 2-3 zone in the last couple possessions there, just to kind of change up, give them a different look defensively.
Coming out of the timeout, Horton and Bryant on top of that zone, Cushing, Goss, and Ferretto on the back line. 9:11 left to play. Delaware up by 30. Pass inside by Head was tipped away. He got it back, though. Greenwich, good look at a 3 from the corner, rattled in and out, and Greenwich now just 3 of 15 on the day. Here's Cushing, 1 dribble to pass to Bryant. Goss all the way up top. Horton as they work the ball around the perimeter. 20 to shoot, 8:51 to play. Goss, Delaware just working some clock. Trying to find a good look. Horton releases on a 3. He's got a quick trigger as that one falls.
Yeah, he could do a little bit of everything, man. He could dribble, get to the basket, finishes with contact, hits the open 3. He's a good talented young guy.
That's 12 points for number 12. The season high. He scored 10 twice and 11 points. Now 12 for Ithiel Horton. And Head with a jump shot from about 15 on the near side. Head just 7 points in this one, 2 of 12 from the field. He's been averaging 25 points per game, was the 6th leading scorer in the conference a season ago, but struggling today a bit as his team only has 28.
Yeah, they've kept him out of the lane and made him take tough shots on the outside.
59-28, Cushing. Over to Horton, inside Goss. Good finish, better luck to find him. Ithiel Horton.
Great execution. You know, that's good job on them. Ran through the set, couple passes, reversed it, diagonal screen, score.
Delaware looking much better on offense to start this, the way they started the second half. As Verretto gets a steal, got a look up. Terry Bryant was wide open down the floor, and Verretto was not looking up at the basketball or with the basketball. Bryant has it now inside to Colin Goss. Goss looking to pass out. Cushing thought about a 3. He's got the 5-9 Norwood defending. Verretto inside to Goss. Goss turns, fires from 10. He shot at 9 and a miss.
Yeah, he shot at 9 and faded against a much smaller player.
As Norwood missing on a 3, here's Verretto. And now Bryant calling for the basketball. He'll walk it up. Davis Long going to check in at the next whistle. Next whistle will bring us to a timeout as we're under 8 minutes. 7:10 left to go. Delaware in control this one. 61-28. Goss to Bryant. They're running some offense, Verretto.
Little inside action. I really like the flow of the Delaware's offense. It just has a like, nice flow, nice ball movement. You could see the guys understanding what coach wants them to do on the offensive side. And the byproduct of that is these guys shooting the ball really well and playing well tonight.
Yeah, a lot of ball movement. Rarely a bad shot for Delaware. Yeah. The ball does not go in. Rarely a bad shot. There was a whistle on the floor, which will bring us to a timeout. 6:52 remaining. 61-28. Hens on their way to 4-1 on the season.
Yeah. Chevy offers three great trucks, so you can find the right truck to fit your lifestyle.
Sometimes a challenge.
Maybe you want the efficiency.
The game like this
size Chevy Colorado.
Find a way to keep talking.
Yeah. Okay, I can't.
No,
right.
Not for you, but just like for both of us.
Yeah.
It's like, how do we explain to listeners, like,
Yeah, that's why I put in the Steve Steinwetto.
It's like, stuff like that is great. Where it's just like, let's talk about somebody.
I got a kid, I think it's Jair Davis. Goes to Sanford.
He's good.
He's up there.
Oh, I see him.
He's up top.
Is he a junior now?
He's a junior, yeah. I think he's top 100 or maybe higher.
We back.
Scott, you're back.
Welcome back here to the Bob Carpenter Center. 61-28 is the score. Delaware on top with 6:52 left to play. And welcome back in. Thank you for joining us on a Sunday here in Newark, Delaware. Busy weekend of Blue Hens sports as Delaware played on Thursday at Cornell basketball. And of course, the football game was here on Saturday. Didn't go the way that Delaware wanted, a loss to Villanova. You know, Villanova has beat Delaware now 12 of the last 13 seasons. Is that unreal or what? Delaware's just cursed, seemingly, against Villanova. But it did not cost them a playoff spot, as we talked about it. Delaware into the playoffs for the first time since 2010. A big congratulations to Danny Rocco and the staff and all of the players for working hard and making that next step in the process for Delaware football. They'll go to James Madison on Saturday at 3 o'clock to start FCS playoffs.
Go get those Dukes.
That's right.
Go get those Dukes.
Madison arrival as well, and now you get a chance to take them on in the playoffs as Colin Gauss took on his man a moment ago, scored on the interior, and it's 63-28 Delaware.
Delaware still in the 2-3. So I think it's, you're up so many points, you don't want to rub it in, just kind of slowed the game down. I think that's a good move on Coach Inglesby's side.
Gordon missing on a three. Basket good on the putback from Dawson Greenwich. And then there's one guy that has come to play for Wilmu who has brought the right attitude, the right energy from the very start of this game. It's Dawson Greenwich.
Yeah, he has. He's definitely has brought an energy, a certain level. And if he could play like that throughout the season for this team, he's going to have a really good year for them.
Absolutely. Only played 10 games last year as a freshman, and now 8 points per game, 9 rebounds per game for Greenwich. He's got 7 today, and he's the lone Wilmu player in double figures with 10 points, missing the free throw. It'll stay at 10 points, but I've been impressed with the young man who played in the blue-gold all-star basketball game here on this floor back in 2017.
Yeah, he and Hayes, and their 4 and 5 are really skilled big guys who can score the basketball. And at their league and their level, they'll have a lot of success throughout the season.
I think so. I think Dan Burke has a solid squad for the CACC. Davis, long three, long missing there. He made 2 3-pointers. Excuse me. Yeah, 2 3-pointers, 3 shots overall against Chestnut Hill on Tuesday. As Haynes, fadeaway jump shot from the foul line. Johnson back in. He grabs a rebound for Delaware. He's approached the 5 minute mark. 5:33 left to play for the Bob Carpenter Center. Horton in double figures for the fourth time this season. Long back to Horton. Jab step, he brings it to the wing. Couple dribbles, bounces to Cushing. Cushing ball fake, a pass to Long. They'll operate beyond the arc. Johnson to Long, cross court. Tipped by Haynes. He'll stay with Delaware, 6 to shoot.
It's good to see Long in the game. Freshman, walk on, tribute to coach, having trust in all his guys.
Talk with Kevin Tritt, Sports Information Director at Delaware, as Cushing drives the lane. Johnson will fire up a three. He misses, rebounded by Gauss. Johnson gets it back. Johnson to the rim and scoring with the left hand. But talking with Kevin Tritt, he said that, they tweet out different videos and scores and information. He said that the Davis Long three-point tweet that he sent out got more likes and retweets than any
other.
So it's always exciting when a walk-on can get in the action. And we feel good about Davis Long being a part of this basketball team for sure. Haynes on the inside over the 6'11". Gauss misses, gets his own rebound, puts it back up and in strong. And that's something you referenced earlier, is Haynes right now a little bit too small for Eric Carter and Gauss, but the effort is there.
Effort,
he's going to do well against the guys in Division II.
Yeah, the effort, the skill, the touch around the basket, good footwork.
65-32 after the make from Haynes. He's got 6 points after not scoring in the first half. Here's Horton. Guarded by Norwood. Jab step spinning into traffic. Cushing lines up with three. Benzenese right. Fires, misses. Good rotation just off to the left.
Yeah, he just hesitated. If you're going to shoot it, just go right into your shot.
Walsh around a couple Delaware defenders. Gets to the foul line. Fades and hits the lefty with a make going left to right.
Yeah, but I mean, they have a good team, man. You know, they have a lot of good guards, good guard play, decent interior play. I'm going to follow these guys the rest of the season, see how they develop.
3:41 to go. They'll play a Division II schedule moving forward. Members of the CACC, the Central Atlantic Collegiate Conference, with head coach Dan Burke. Cushing at three. Went right into that one. Maybe shouldn't have. He was well defended in the corner. And a miss for Jacob Cushing, struggling a bit from three-point range today, although shooting very well on the season. 1 of 5 today for Cush after that miss. 3:15 to go. Delaware on top, 65-34. This one's been decided for quite some time. Norwood leans into one from 15, a miss. Horton soaring for the rebound.
Yeah. Delaware coach is going to his bench, going deep into his bench.
I see Connor Rufo into the game.
Yeah.
And a Sanford product.
Oh, is he a Sanford
product? Coming in, that's right. Stan Waterman.
Up the street.
And there's a Sanford connection, I believe, on the bench with Wilmington University.
Yeah.
As Vernon Dupree, one of the assistant coaches, he's in the Waterman family.
He's in the Waterman family, yeah.
Impressive stuff. Stan Waterman, of course, he is the son-in-law.
He's the son-in-law,
Stan
so
Waterman
he would be.
Is, is Stan, right. One of the all-time great coaches in high school basketball. I was going to limit it to in the state of Delaware, but I'd say in the game of high school basketball all around. He is just a legend and doing great things at Sanford School.
And he's a former point guard, Delaware.
That's right.
Yeah. Mr. Everything. Great guy. Good luck, Stan. Have a great season.
That's right. We love Stan Waterman. And Champ Mosley was a Sanford guy. Yeah. Played 4 years, just finished his career last year. As Jacob Cushing got his shot blocked at the rim, came down hard. He's slow to get up. Last thing you want to have happen in a game like this is to lose somebody for injury. He's wincing a bit as he comes up the floor. Danny Walsh not waiting for him, and he gets to the rim and scores for two. 67-36, and Martin Inglesby going to call a timeout. He wanted to keep things moving just to make a substitution, but I believe they're going to have to make an immediate timeout. Martin Inglesby was just wanted to sub in Connor Rufo to get him max amount of time on the court, but this has to be a media timeout because it is the timeout for media has not been taken yet. So we'll take a timeout with him. 1:51 to play. Connor Rufo coming in when we return.
This is Dr. Michael Axe of First Aid Orthopedics.
Was the last break not a minute long? Or we were
just from the beach to the bridge and beyond. If you have shoulder or knee pain or a condition in another body region, please call us.
The last break, I think, was a minute. Hold on to check.
Right. I mean,
we treat muscle, tendon, bone, or joint ailments from your neck to your toes with the latest techniques to include PRP and stem cells.
For more post-game information,
go to our website, firstaidortho.com.
We'll
chat with physicians and staff, but you should Facebook with us, especially on patient testimonial Tuesdays. First Aid Orthopedics, a team of top docs taking care of Delaware from the beach to the bridge and beyond.
Mike Cates Restaurant on Main Street is not only the home for the Blue Hens football coaches.
Okay, I missed it. The break is only 30 seconds.
Yeah, see, that's
this
what
happened. This season, celebrate Delaware football by wearing blue and gold to Klondike Cates on Sunday and receive 20% off to 9 p.m. Plus, don't miss Half Price Burger Night on Mondays and take part in the New Art tradition that is Half Price Nachos every Tuesday at Cates. Visit KlondikeCates.com. Klondike Cates on Main Street, a proud supporter of Blue Hens football.
You're listening to UD Men's Basketball on 94.7 WDSD and iHeartRadio.
67-36, Delaware's lead against Wilmington University. As we look ahead at the Delaware schedule, Wilmington University today, then a break for Thanksgiving. November 23rd, Delaware back at the Bob will take on UNCG. And then on the 26th, Louisiana Tech at the Bob Carpenter Center before hitting the road at UMES and at Columbia on the 30th of November, and to start December off in the Ivy League. But Delaware going to start off the season 4-1. It's a great place to be. Right. And they gave Maryland all that they could handle down the road to start the year.
Yeah, they did. It's fun. Delaware starting off 4-1. I don't know when the last time we've been 4-1. But, you know, it's a bright future. It'll be a good year for these guys this year.
If Delaware gets to 4-1, looks like they will. In fact, their best start through five games since 2004 for the Blue Hens. So very impressive stuff. Connor Rufo for three. Connor Rufo off the bench and a triple made by the Sanford product, the local product out of Hocassin, Delaware. I love to see Connor Rufo in on the action. Walsh with a triple on the other end, in and out. And let's feed that kid. Big smile on it. Well, he's trying not to smile. I got a bigger smile than he does right now. But so do the fans. They love watching Connor Rufo play. And Davis Long trying to add to his season total. He misses on the layup. Let's see if we can't get Long and Rufo another shot the rest of the way.
It's good to see the guys on the bench cheering for those who don't play as much. You can tell that's a good team supporting each other.
And a timeout taken on the floor by the official, I believe, to wipe the floor a bit. And a substitution being made as Danny Sullivan going to check in, one of the players that doesn't play too much for Will Muke, getting in on the action just his second game. But Delaware going to win this one, 70-38. See if they can add to their total, as I'm sure they'll run a set for Long or Rufo. Long to Rufo. Let it fly, Connor. Jab step. Driving the lane. Connor Rufo. Kick out Horton. 14 to shoot. Here's Goss. Long off the screen. Pass inside to Goss. And that's one thing Long will have to work on, is he's played the games. He's turned the ball over a little bit too much. But picking nits at this point. 70-40 after the layup on the other side. And Delaware just walked this one up. Get across half court and make it official. Delaware 4-1 for the first time since 2004. A great start to the year for the Hens, and a 70-40 victory at home. We'll take the time out here for the American Spirit Federal Credit Union post-game show. When we come back, Ty and I will wrap this one up, give our final thoughts. We'll also hear from head coach Martin Inglesby. It's all coming up on the Blue Hens post-game show, brought to you by American Spirit Federal Credit Union.
Keep moving, keep moving.